हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम डीलिंग विथ 9th स्टैंडर्ड इंग्लिश, दैट इज फर्स्ट चैप्टर, द बेस्ट एडवाइस आई एवर हैड. प्लीज ओपन योर बुक. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लेसन, हियर आर सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पर्सनैलिटीज टू आइडेंटिफाई. फर्स्ट ए पार्ट, आइडेंटिफाई द ग्रेट पर्सनैलिटीज. You please match, write these, okay, in your textbook. And B part I have done for you. The first woman president of the UN General Assembly was Vijayalakshmi Pandit. Second one, the first woman judge of the Supreme Court of India is Fatima Bibi. The first woman IPS officer of India is Kiran Bedi. The first woman president of India is Pratibha Patil. The first woman prime minister of India is Indira Gandhi. The first woman governor in India is Sarojini Naidu. These only are the A part. Those are the pictures. You please write those pictures' name. Okay, who are those? In next class, I will give you the answer. Before starting this lesson, we will see the author, what she has done in her life. About the author, Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit, she was in the year 1900 to 1990, was an Indian diplomat, politician and a sister of India's first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru. She was the sister of whose Prime Minister, first Prime Minister of India. Who he was? He was Jawaharlal Nehru. She was active in the Indian freedom movement and held high national and international positions. She was very active. This lady was very active in the Indian freedom movement. She was in national level as well as in the international level. Her position was very much high. She was greatly influenced by Gandhiji and became identified with the struggle for independence. Gandhiji used to like her more. Okay, she was well-known person to Gandhiji. And she fought for the independence also. She was imprisoned by the British on three different occasions in 1932 to 1933, 1940 and 1942 to 1943. She was imprisoned means she has gone to the prison also. Who had put her in the prison? The Britishers had put. Okay, for three reasons she had gone for the jail. After her husband's death in 1944, she traveled in the United States from late 1944 to early 1946, mainly on a lecture tour. After the death of her husband, where she had gone? She had gone for the United States. After India's independence, she entered the diplomatic service and became India's ambassador to the Soviet Union, the United States, Mexico, Ireland, during which time she was also the Indian High Commissioner to the United Kingdom. She had become the India's ambassador, okay, to the Soviet Union, and she had become the commissioner also of United Kingdom and Spain, and even the Spain also. In 1953, she became the first woman president of the United Nations General Assembly. She was the first woman president of United Nations the General Assembly. Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit died on December 1, 1990. When she died? She died in December 1st, that was in 1990. President Ramaswamy Venkatramana described Mrs. Pandit as a luminous strand in the tempestry of India's freedom struggle. Who at that time when she died, who was the president there? Ramaswamy Venkatramana was the president of India. He was very much happy with her work and he told that you are the bright shining light of India. Distinctive in her elegance, courage and dedication, Mrs. Pandit was an asset to the national movement. She was very famous. Okay, now let us see the lesson. Okay, the lesson given below is an article written by Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit, one of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's sister. Okay, this lesson is written by Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit. She was the sister of Jawaharlal Nehru. She wrote it for the Reader's Digest. For what purpose she had written? She had written for the Reader's Digest. It is a magazine. When she was the High Commissioner of India in the United Kingdom. When she was High Commissioner, at that time she had written this letter for the magazine, which it is the Reader's Digest. Okay, now let us begin the lesson. Now let us start the explanation. First para, the best advice I ever had came from one of the greatest souls the world has ever known, Mahatma Gandhi, on a sunny afternoon a decade ago. Okay, she has telling that a advice I ever had in my life was given by Mahatma Gandhi. When he had given that? In a sunny afternoon. She is telling the time also when he has given a best advice to her in decade ago. Means decade means it is 10 years. Okay, when she had written this before, it was 10 years ago. Most people pass through a period of anguish when their belief is in humanity is at a low ebb. Okay, she will tell that in my period, anguish means it is a physical pain. She had a physically pained. And humanity, what is the meaning of humanity here? Faith on human beings or how much others shows love to you. She was very much depressed. At that time, she was feeling that nobody will show love to her. And low ebb means less level love, showing in low level. She was thinking like that. I was in such a period. Okay, she was in very much sad at that time when she was writing this story. My husband had recently died. What her husband? He was recently died means in few days her husband had died. She has written her real story in this. Okay. My deep sorrow over his loss was followed by the humiliating realization that in the eyes of Indian law, I had no individual existence. When her husband had died, at that time she was feeling very much alone in the society. And she is telling that humiliating. What is the meaning of humiliating? She was very much disturbed. Okay. And she was very much disturbed because in Indian law, they were not believing, they were not leaving her to live individual existence. Existence means way of living life or how she is important in this society. How much after the husband has died, how much importance they will give in this society, she was not knowing. Okay, in the Indian law, how much it is, she was telling to herself. Along with other Indian women, I had participated for years with men in the national struggle for freedom, working and suffering side by side with them until it had finally been achieved. Yet in law, we women were still recognized only through our relationship to men. Seer, what she is telling that in India, in the national struggle of freedom, I was very much suffering, okay, like other women. And she is telling that if the husband has died means our recognizing in this society is very low, okay, we are not recognized by our own name. So she is feeling very much bad there. Now, as a widow without a son, I was not entitled to any share of the family property. See here, in the Indian law before, how it was, if the son is not there means the then they won't get the family property. Family property means their own property they were not getting. This Vijayalakshmi Pandit was not having a son. Okay, what is the meaning of untitled here? Did not claim. She was not claiming any family property. Nor were my two daughters. She was having only two daughters. She was not having the son. So she was not able to claim the property of her family. Her family means her husband's side family. Okay. I resented this galling position. Okay, what is the meaning of resented here? Feeling bitter here. Feeling very much sad. Feeling very much guilty. Okay, galling means annoying or disturbed. She was very much disturbed because of this. I was bitter towards those members of my family who supported this antiquated law. What is the meaning of antiquated here? Antiquated means outdated, old law. What was the old law here? If the son is not there and her husband has died means she is not able to get any property from her husband's side. That was the law before it was. So it is called as antiquated. Antiquated means it is outdated law. Okay, come to fourth para. Fourth para. At this time, I went to pay my respects to Gandhiji and say goodbye before leaving for America to take a part in a conference. Okay, what she decided? She decided to go to America. At that time, before going to America, she went to meet Gandhiji and why she had gone there? She went to give the respect and say goodbye to him. She had gone and even she told that I am going to the conference to America. She told like that. After our talk, he asked, have you made your peace with your relatives? Okay. When she went there and she met Gandhiji, at that time Gandhiji will ask, have you met your family members and have you sorted out your problems? Peace with your relatives means you have talked with your relatives, or what he will ask to her. I was amazed that he would take sides against me. Yes, she was very shocked. Why? Because he took side of my husband relatives. He was in favor of my husband relatives. He did not listen to me. He is against me. So she felt very bad and she was very much shocked. I have not quarreled with anyone, I replied. Okay, she replied, I have not fought with anyone. She told to Gandhiji, but I refuse to have anything to do with those who take advantage of an out-own law to create a difficult and humiliating situation for me. And again, what she will tell that? I do not want to have any connection with them because they are taking outdated law and standing against me. What she told? They are using a old law and they are humiliating. They are disturbing me very much and they are standing against me. So I don't want to talk with them, she will tell to Gandhiji. Okay, next, fifth para. Gandhiji looked out on the window for a moment. After listening to her voice, what Gandhiji did? He will go and he will stand near the window. Then he turned to me and smiled and said, "You will go and say goodbye because courtesy and decency demand this." Okay, what did Gandhiji will tell? That you have to meet them. You have to go and meet your relatives because of, and you have to go near them and you have to say goodbye to them because you are going to America, he will tell. What is the meaning of courtesy here? Being very soft or in good manners. Courtesy means good manners. You are having the good manners. Okay. So you have to go near them and you have to say goodbye to them, he will tell. What is the meaning of decency here? Proper behavior. You have to behave proper there to your family members, he will tell. In India, we will attach importance to these things. Yes, again what he will tell? In India, we are having this attachment. Attachment means this attachment means we are maintaining this relationship. Okay, and he even tell that in India importance are given to these things. Even now we maintain our relationship. In India we are maintaining our relationship, so you please go and meet your family members, he will tell. Next para. "No, I declared, not even to please you will I go to those who wish to harm me." What she will tell? She will tell that I won't go. Okay, I don't want to go there because, and I don't want to talk also with them because even to please you, and I won't say goodbye also because they are thinking only to harm me. They are thinking only to hurt me. So I don't want to go near them, she will tell. "No one can harm you except yourself." What Gandhiji will tell? No one here, no one can harm you except yourself. Here, this line is very important to you. Listen, it is like a quotation. Yes or no? What Gandhiji is telling? No one can harm you. Instead, you harm yourself. He said, still smiling. He will say these words, smiling. "I see enough bitterness in your heart to cause you injury unless you check it." He also tells this sentence that your really very rough way of telling, so it hurts you. So your bitterness means you're having the bitter in your heart. So you're telling this. So you please go and meet your family, he will tell. Okay, till here I will stop your chapter. Next class I will continue with your eighth paragraph. Thank you.